We are in southern Ireland, near Killarney, about the year 1800. At the home of Mrs. Cragan, a widow of good Irish county family, a party of friends are toasting the health of her son, Hardress, who is shortly to marry a wealthy heiress.
Occasions such as this.
Well, what then?
When friendship, love, and wedded bliss, the soul of honor, power of beauty, impress upon us as a duty, the task of wishing happiness and happiness and well. We can't, I'm sure, do less.
Less than what?
Than Hardress Cragan. Here's to your good health.
Cheer, cheer, cheer.
for a speech are far too strong. So if I may, I'll answer in a song. Not to see. He kisses the dark and he flirts with the fair, and nearly depressed by the burden of care. We all would get married, we all eat, but yet the days of his freedom hold not to regret. A bachelor's life is so careless and free, from beauty to beauty, unchained flutters he. Comes a moment when freedom may fall, and chains that we laugh at prove welcome to all. Our pride may deceive us, but soon comes the fall. Who looks where he's going when young beauty calls? Who looks where he's going when true love does call? The chains forged by woman are pleasant and bright. Sure, some would be free when a prisoner's delight. But single or married, you'll find me the same. When kindred or friendship can proper acclaim, a smile or a handshake is welcome to me. For old friends are good friends, I know you'll agree. And often I trust when my life's in the seal, the comrades of you I shall find gathered here. And then we'll look back and a tribute we'll pay. Tonight, 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 and today's like today.
He claims the finest horse.
Upon my word, that's so
true. Indeed, your legs are half as fine as mine.
Use your brains. Mine's quite as fine.
Exaggeration you incline.
Would you insinuate at all?
You mean, sir, that I tell a lie?
Aye, don't quarrel, friends, about horses. Very plain, for wisest course is to try them out you will allow a steeplechase.
And why not here and now?
Yes, now is the moment of here is the place. It couldn't be better, so why not a race? Yes, now is the moment and here is the place. It couldn't be better, so why not a race? The moment that happens is brighter than day. So out with your horses and off on your way. So out with your horses and off on your way. So out with your horses and off on your way.
Yes, now is the moment and here is the place. It couldn't
Excitedly, the guests hurry out to witness the moonlight horse race. Mrs. Cragen is now left on her own, when she is startled by the arrival of Mr. Corrigan, the family lawyer. He is urgently in need of money and reminds Mrs. Cragen that the mortgage on her property has run out. Mr. Corrigan also suggests to her that if she is relying on her son's marriage to Miss Anne Shute to provide the funds for paying this, it's not a very good security. Perhaps Mrs. Cragen is not aware that her son pays nightly visits to some other girl who lives across the lake, and that it's her son's faithful boatman, Danny Mann, who rows him across each night and is already in his boat on the lake below, singing as he waits for his master's coming.
Oh,
Mrs. Cragen is horrified to see that what Mr. Corrigan has told her about her son seems to be true. They are setting out across the water. But where? They seem to be looking for a signal. A light appears at the other side of the lake. Mrs. Cragen is thunderstruck as she stands with Mr. Corrigan, watching her son and his boatman depart across the water. She must find out who this unknown girl is. Just at that moment, they see Miles passing along the road. Miles Nacopoline, a gay rogue, if there ever was one. Salmon poacher, horse dealer, with an illegal whiskey still tucked away somewhere in the hills. They call to him, and Mr. Corrigan bribes him to find out who this girl is. Now, Miles knows her well, for he's long been in love with her himself. She is Eileen O'Connor, the Colleen Bourne, the Lily of Killarney, in fact.
It is a charming girl I love, she comes from Garion. She's gentle than the dove, her hair is brown and flowing. Her eyes are the softest blue, her breath as sweet as morning dew. Her step is lighter than the fawn, and oh, she's called the Colleen. Botheration, botheration, a likeness I never shall see. There is but one Colleen Bourne, and she does not love me. Ye ask me what I'm looking for, then listen to the sequel. The Colleen Bourne I love no more, when I can find her equal. Mayhap now such a girl is here, with step as light and eye as clear. Ah, she'll be welcome as the dawn, although she's not the Colleen Bourne. Botheration! Botheration, a likeness I never shall see. There is but one Colleen Bourne, and she does not love me.
Miles decides he must go across the lake to warn Eily that her secret is in danger of discovery. For Eily is not only in love with Hardress Cragan, but already is secretly married to him, and living in Danny Mann's cottage overlooking the lake. We find her there, waiting for her husband's coming.
My table's bright shining. He
While Eily is waiting for Hardress, she receives a call from Father Tom, the parish priest. He urges Eily to insist that Hardress tells his family about their marriage, but she feels that the county folk would never accept her. Miles arrives too and sets out to mix a bowl of punch. With Danny's mother to make a quartet, they sing, as they drink, an old Irish song.
Let the huntsman praise his hounds, the shepherd his jewels sent in long. But I more blessed than they, spend each happy night and day with my charming little Krushkin. My charming little Krushkin. Immortal and divine, great Bacchus, god of wine, create me by adoption, thy son. In hope that you'll comply, that my glass shall ne'er be dry, for my smiling little Krushkin, la la la. My smiling little Krushkin, la.
From the cream of Krushkin, from the garb of honey, from the cream of honey,
Oh.
Eily is left alone to welcome her husband, who bitterly and carelessly tells her that their secret marriage can shortly be revealed. For as he and his mother will soon be beggars and outcasts, no one will care what bride a Cragan may take. Anschutz's fortune alone could have saved him, but that is out of the question. Moved by his self-pity, Eily offers to give up her marriage certificate, and then no one need know, for the priest who joined them is dead and had, in addition, been disgraced by his bishop. She places her treasured marriage lines in his hand.
Whatever fears assail my heart, my love will dare them all. A flame less pure may soon expire when breezes coldly blow. My love is fed by deathless fire, and though the storm can blow.
I will trust when I will have my love, my life, my all. A flameless glow. she has slighted, so a hand that fond to me.
You know my name, outlaw,
what is I implore, oh, my forbear?
Tis true, I am an outlaw, tis true, I am the bird, but my pride is as high as yours may be, and such a dirty trick as this I'd scorn.
If not to him, to me this light restore.
I mean, do you love me more?
So you are betrayed.
Oh, Father, spare me, I implore.
That paper I demand, that paper I demand.
You love the vow we made.
This would mean, alas, I dare not tell. So to our love, forever a farewell.
Why then, I swear, no. Father, Audrey, stay.
Forgive me.
Some days later, the local hunt is having a meet in the grounds of Torwick Craig. Among the riders is Miss Anne Shute herself.
Thank you.
As Anne watches the hunters disappear, Hardress approaches. His mind is sorely tried by his failure to get Eily to give him up. Anne urges him to tell her what is wrong, for she's very fond of him.
Oh, hey.
man goes to ride after the others. Danny appears, and in dismay at his master's dilemma, reveals a villainy we had not suspected. He offers to put Eily out of the way. Hardress refuses in horror, where Danny says, "Think it over, and if at any time you change your mind, send me your gloves, a token, and the deed will be done." Hardress still refuses, but on a later occasion, Danny makes a similar offer to Mrs. Cragen, but this time by packing her off to America. If only the young master will send him his glove as a token of his agreement.
Trust me, mistress, his glove would be a token as plain as any word that's spoken. I've sworn that I'll obey him, then there be no one to gainsay him.
But why? His glove!
That is a secret, never mind, tricks him and me. Why ask, you soon shall see.
But if he give it me, if his freedom would it secure,
It would. Of that mistress you may be sure.
Then wait for me, and you shall see.
Oh, Colin Vaughn, your reign is over. Your reign is over. Forget your high-born lover, your high-born lover. 'Tis not you alone that love him, other hearts watch above him. 'Tis not you alone that love him, other hearts watch above him. Oh, I give my life tomorrow, could he be spared a moment's sorrow? And if your life's his darling son, and if your life's his darling son, I take it, as I want my own. I take it, as I would my.
Then.
Oh, let my fears expire. But calling on no more, no more, his home shall be. Don't fear our charms, but be for fate. Oh.